Hi, I'm Dr. Richard Doty, the director of the Smell and Taste Center at Penn Medicine, the Department of ENT. I'm here today to discuss the effects of COVID-19 on your ability to smell. We now know that smell loss is among the very first signs of COVID-19, and nearly everyone who has COVID-19 has some degree of smell loss, at least early in the disease process. We know that the most common cause of smell loss in the general population, aside from COVID, is from viruses. Upper respiratory infections, for example, are a common way in which smell is damaged. Indeed, in the clinic, the majority of people that we see who come in report they had a bad cold or influenza, got over the cold, months have gone by, but they discovered that they can no longer smell. And that's because the viruses essentially enter those cells and damage them. Now, in some cases, viruses are what we call neurotropic. They enter into nerve cells, which then can, the virus can then propagate up into the brain through the olfactory receptor cells and cause a number of different diseases. Poliovirus is a good example. It's been known since the 1930s that a major route of poliovirus into the brain is through the olfactory pathways. At the University of Pennsylvania, we've been doing collaborative research with a number of institutions, including researchers in Tehran, where we've basically done the first study to show that, in fact, smell loss is present measured objectively. There's been lots of self-reports of smell loss occurring, but nobody has actually given olfactory tests. In relation to COVID, we know that many people get their sense of smell back. Indeed, studies that are going on here at the University of Pennsylvania in conjunction with other institutions show, in fact, that within 2, 3, 4 weeks, most people get their smell back, perhaps not quite to the level they had it before. On the other hand, somewhere around 1/4 or more of the people will have long-lasting smell loss. We don't know yet whether it's permanent, but it's quite possible that in many cases it is permanent. If you're at home and you're concerned about your loss, losing your sense of smell, you can take various things from your pantry or cabinet, vanilla extract, common things that you have in the house, and see if in fact you can smell them. If you discover that coffee has no taste, or chocolate seems not to have any taste other than bitterness or sweetness, then it's quite likely that you have a smell problem. We know that when you chew food, the molecules go up through the rear of the nasal cavity, the so-called nasal pharynx, to reach the receptors at the top of the nose, the olfactory receptors. For that reason, things like coffee and chocolate do not have any, quote, taste. It's really a smell. Everything we think of as taste, with the exception of sweet, sour, bitter, salty, and something called savory or umami, everything but that is that we call tastes are really smells. So chocolate, strawberry, steak sauce, butterscotch, all of these things are really dependent upon the sense of smell. So many people think they have taste loss, but actually the loss is due to decreased flavor sensation from the sense of smell. If this loss has happened over a very rapid period of time, there's some possibility that you indeed have COVID-19. You should contact your doctor, who should do further testing to evaluate that if you're concerned. Also, obviously, being tested for COVID-19, if the tests are available to you, is a smart move. You certainly can get in contact with the ENT department at the University of Pennsylvania, other institutions, and so on. But it's possible that they have COVID-19 virus, and for that reason, they need to seek medical help. Penn Medicine is currently seeing patients with a focus on individuals who have the most serious complications. Penn Medicine has been largely practicing telemedicine for the safety of the patients and others involved. However, we're rapidly evolving to bring patients back in to the clinic in a safe and proper manner. It's being done in a stepwise fashion to ensure safety for those patients that need to come in, that will be available or is available currently. The vast majority of cases still, though, we're doing by telemedicine to ensure the safety of all involved. the ENT department, as well as other departments at the School of Medicine, is very concerned about safety of the patient and of the doctors themselves. And they're taking extraordinary precautions to ensure safety when a patient enters into the hospital, as well as when they're evaluated in the ENT department or other departments. Personal protective gear is provided, masks, hand washing, all the things that are important to ensure that the virus won't spread among patients or among the doctors and patients. I think Penn has a very good record along these lines, sanitizes the rooms, and there'll be personal spacing between individuals in the waiting areas. The sense of smell is much more important than people realize. And in addition to determining the flavor of foods and beverages, if you can't smell, you're less likely to detect leaking natural gas, spoiled food, and other environmental dangers. So paying attention to this sense is critical. The U.S. Armed Forces no longer allows people into the armed forces if they can't smell, at least according to medical regulations. You can imagine in situations in a submarine or an aircraft where they're burning wires or there's something causing a problem and you can't smell it, you're at danger as well as putting other people that you're associated with in danger. So I can't emphasize more than enough that sense of smell is critical. Over the age of 80, 3 out of 4 people have demonstrable smell loss. And indeed, a disproportionate number of those people die in accidental gas poisonings. So just like the other senses, it's important to pay attention to your sense of smell and seek medical help when it declines. These are quite unprecedented times, and patients really, if you feel you've lost your smell or have other problems that you need treatment for, it's very important to call Penn ENT and discuss the issues. We are really there to help you. We want to be certain that you weather this unprecedented period, and we're concerned about your health and really are willing to help you.